saw us here when we were a couple years ago. Nice. Cool. Thank you so much for coming back. We appreciate everyone being here. This is super special for us. Now, I'm going to turn to the crowd because I need a favor from you guys.
Make it so scary.
Yeah.
You might die with this favor. Is there anyone in the crowd right now celebrating something tonight? Anything at all? Anything at all?
Is someone not celebrating something?
Oh, in the back. I see the
hand. Birthday!
I got fired from a job that I fucking hate.
Well, come on! Well, ladies and gentlemen, please give it up for Keo! So you're fired from a job that you fucking hate.
Yes.
What job was that?
I did disability case management for an insurance company that will go unnamed, but life is brighter under this certain celestial body. Wow. Wow.
What is the name of the company rhyme with? You know.
Unfun Life Financial.
Could be anything. Where are you from, Kim?
I'm born and raised in Vancouver, actually.
The Coup!
Yo, Van City.
No, legit, we've been trying to push the Coup all weekend, and every single time they go, no one calls it that.
As a born and raised Vancouver, right there, it is called the Coup in certain.
Thank you. I heard Van City and I was like, Van, go home! That should have been crickets. Cool, so you're from Vancouver. Let's talk about your parents for a second.
For sure, let's totally do that.
Chances are they also lived in Vancouver when you did.
They did.
Tell me a little bit about your parents. What did they do?
Both of my parents were actually like high school PE teachers and coaches. So like my dad was a football, wrestling, rugby coach. My mom was like volleyball, basketball, track and field.
Yeah. Nice. Oh, I'm sorry.
Yeah, teacher.
Is that high school?
Go teachers.
Yeah, I was like, oh.
Teachers is the name of the team at their high school.
Hey, I'm not gonna lie, I got real excited about it. I was like, okay, Canada, I see what you're doing. Great, cool. So, did you grow up in Vancouver proper, or like what neighborhood of Vancouver?
Okay, I grew up in North Vancouver, and I feel like because Vancouver is in the name, it's Vancouver proper.
Is that true, guys?
No.
I grew up where the rich white kids that think they're ghetto live.
Is that true, guys? So elaborate on that a little bit.
Basically.
You think they're ghetto?
Yeah.
Okay.
Like, they're like, yeah, listen to Biggie Smalls, I know the struggles of the world. And it's like, you have like a trust fund and you go to the every day.
Yeah, man, the only thing I got is my Sean John, you know? Here. Do you have any brothers or sisters?
I have a brother and I have a half-brother and half-sister.
All right, what are their names?
My brother's name is Joey, my half-sister's name is Jody. Weird.
Joey Jody,
and then my half-brother's name is Brett.
Okay. If you could describe them in a couple of words, what would it be for each one?
Greg is like
successful.
Brad, like retired at the age of 36, successful.
Okay.
Jody is. You know what? Jody's pseudo celebrity. That's the word I'm going with.
Oh.
Pseudo celeb. And Joey is just.
Joey's Joey, guys.
Yeah, Joey's Joey. Joey is basically the epitome of what happened with the sitcom Joey. Like, that's just. Joey's my brother.
Oh, okay.
I call that a third degree burn.
Maybe next time I'm introduced with the least successful.
You really did not bury the lead. No, that's great. Cool. I didn't ask your parents' names. What are their names?
Bill and Margaret.
And if you could describe them, other than their jobs, but just a couple words that describe them.
For my dad, it would definitely be like assertive.
Okay.
And for my mother, it would be avoidant.
I'm being so honest, you guys.
We know none of her family is here. Except for maybe Greg. Greg's in the back counting his money.
But Greg is bankrolling this entire show.
That could be true. Lots of toonies.
Thank you, Greg.
Greg, if you're looking for an investment opportunity, hello. Cool, that's awesome. So you just got fired from your job. Was that today?
That was Thursday.
Okay, so it just happened last week.
Yeah.
Are you on the hook for more work? Are you gonna take some time off? What's coming up?
I have an opportunity now to make my life like super, super awesome and get to do more like stuff and art, have like art be a part of my life more so.
Okay.
It's like, pretty new.
Specifically, what type of art?
Improv and photography.
Woo! Yeah. That's awesome.
Yeah.
Photography.
I feel like it's just you and me, and like this is like a laugh track.
There are other people here.
Someone just meowed.
Great. Well, is there anything in your life coming up that you're looking forward to or you're dreading a little bit? Just like big picture stuff.
Big picture stuff.
Yeah.
Big picture stuff is the fact that I get to have more control over my life and the way that that landscape looks than I ever have before.
Okay. Woo, that's awesome.
Can I ask a question?
Yeah, absolutely.
How did you get fired?
I did a lot of phone calls in my job, and I take issue with people being complete fucking assholes. So that apparently in customer service is not what you should do. Is like,
I mean, to be fair, normally when I call customer service, it goes, we're probably recording these phone calls for future training and or probably firing.
The exact phrase that I believe got me fired was, if not being able to protect my own emotional and mental well-being is a part of my job description, then I don't fucking want this job.
I think it might have just been the fucking part.
Yeah. You just worked up to the point of cursing. If you didn't curse, you probably would have still had your shitty job you didn't want.
If only.
I know, right?
If only.
Anything else? Any other questions?
I don't know. Do you have, like, a boyfriend or
a boyfriend? Literally. Boyfriend or girlfriend?
Just whatever you want. Do you have a romantic aspect of your life?
I do have a romantic aspect of my life. If you can pinpoint that to one person, I don't know if you can say it.
Oh! He's out of the fruit club!
So what are you saying? How many people are involved in this? And can Richie get in?
Come on, I just was curious, but let me know.
Are you seriously asking me how many people I'm
sure
dating? There are like two or three prospects and one person I'm steadily dating. Woo!
What are all of their names? Sigmund Freud said, the mundane details of our everyday life make for some of the wildest dreams. So ladies and gentlemen, please enjoy what we think are Kia's dreams.
Fuck me? Well, listen, dear. Excuse me, what's your name, Kia? I wanna talk.
of freelancing. Improv, artistry.
Are you here? I believe I booked an improvised photography session. Where should I put my bag that's also a little panda?
You can use it in the shot.
What?
Yes.
I can keep my clothes on today.
Yes, you can get naked too. You can do whatever you want because improv and photography combined equal you.
I did not come all the way from Milan to hear such undirected nonsense. I want some pointers, and I want some pointers.
Now, where I think that gal.
What? Where can I put my panda bag?
You can put your panda bag right here. All right, I'm glad we went up and down the steps I have in my apartment. Here.
What is this?
It's a photo of you I printed off of the internet. Now you hand me the fucking panda bag.
What? Why would you print a photo of me and give it to me when I get it here?
Look, I'm Kia, okay?
Are you?
Yes, and you are being very presumptuous. I want you to let go of all this Milanitude you have.
I've never heard that word before.
I need everyone in the room to shut up, because here comes Successful Brain! Shut up! You shut up! Unless you have $1 million, y'all shut up! And by 1 million, I mean $1,400 million. That's over $1,400 million.
Greg, I'm so happy you're here and that your app and software and everything you did is doing so well.
Some people say they make it happen. I made it happen, okay?
That is so fun. You are so fun.
You're so rich and hunky. What is your name, sexy big man?
My name's Greg. Unless you're offering me improvised photography session, I'm leaving.
Look, improvised photography for you two.
Ooh.
Improvised photography for you two.
Oh.
I promise not to put the video on you two. Improvised photography for you two.
Okay.
My brother Greg, this girl with long legs. Maybe you can do a cha-cha slide and I will video. And I will get my camera. I promise not to stammer. And I want to get this photo photography in front of my website, kid.
Oh, how about I take my shirt off and let these girls air out? Do you mind if I let my head down? I'm about to be naked for $1 million.
I'm sorry, were you guys saying something? I'm just counting my money. I don't give a fuck about nothing.
What do you mean? Use the energy in my eyes and smiles to decide if he says they're ready to improvise.
Well, first of all, please put away your saggy breasts because I got the money in there. Shit's the best. Okay, you know what? You just keep on going, and I'm gonna keep on acting, because that's where my life's going.
It's over, it's over. I've gone back to Milan. I'm gonna be skipping all the way home, and I'm gonna smoke a Milan bomb. I don't want to come in this room. I'm going to be in the kitchen. If you need me, yell, I'm not coming.
I just want to let you both know I was fired by life.
Oh, yeah, I'm going to avoid this. I'll be in the other room, and I won't be listening.
Look, do it for the teachers, okay?
You're my school basketball teacher! You know, I helped come up with that name for the team.
I think it's really good.
Thank you.
Bunch of students and you're a bunch of teachers.
Yes. But it's like, you're the teachers. I get me.
So
what, you guys don't care at all? That I'm now unemployed? Mom, you left. Look, you don't mind at all? That I'm now flying my own life? I'm Granvilleing and vaudevilleing through the Vancouver streets?
You don't have to use Vancouver specifics with us. We know what you're doing.
I'm here, and I've put on all this different sports equipment to deal with these emotional problems. I'm here for you. Partially.
Look, guys, I just want you to know that I love you both and that I hope you support my decision to no longer do some of the most ethically questionable things that are legal.
Are you kidding me? Your brother's success renders everything else useless. You can do whatever you want.
Yeah, but what about Jody? He was on some Nickelodeon shows.
We can do whatever we want. We can literally bathe in money from now until infinity if we wanted to.
To be honest, for a second there, I almost forgot we had a fourth son. But it's all right.
Well, we don't have a fourth son. It's a half.
Oh, that's why I guess I forgot.
He's the failure from the Friends spinoff.
To deal with your news.
Yeah, absolutely. I'm gonna go hang out with one of the four people I'm fucking.
Ooh, baby. You're acting foul, ball. I might spike you and then juggle your balls. You wanna play baseball or you wanna play volleyball?
Sports freaks.
Ooh, put my breath on your hand. Home run, grand slam. Goddamn, you're the pitcher, I'm the catcher, we're mad. Yes, you're the best. Let me take off this vest. Oh my God, in this mask, you're something that I must grab.
Rendezvous in North Vancouver. You're the nicest guy who thinks he's not white I've ever met.
What am I now, Chop Lugu?
Yes. All of you boys are expendable to me. I'm a cool, trendy goddess of the stage.
Yo, Kia,
what about me? You're the worst guy that I'm fucking. None of you even have a savings account or a checking account. Just loose cash.
Oh, I got 99 problems and Kia's all of them.
You guys are a bunch of turd sandwiches. And I fucked you and I'm leaving you all.
From 100 to 0, real quick.
Look, my apps are going insane right now, alright? I've got Bumble, Tinder, Canadian Tinder.
Oh, should I swipe right on this guy? Sorry!
Just a normal guy who talks like a normal person.
I hear you're a big celebrity. That's crazy.
I'm more of like a pseudo-celebrity. I just basically live off Greg's money at this point.
Tell me what you do, Jody. Tell me what you do, Jody. Jody, that's the known celebrity.
Okay.
also, I was on the front of a cereal box when I was 8. It kind of rocked. I felt like a celebrity, and then I entered my early teens.
That was really cool, but everybody thought you were much more famous at my school. I didn't know that it was only on a cereal box. I thought that maybe you had been on a show on Fox.
No!
Yeah. I mean, I'm like 35 now.
I basically
hang out around this aisle and pick
up. Oh, you're sad. You're real sad.
Yeah, but my brother's a millionaire.
Oh, old commercials.
Oh, man, this girl's wasted. Oh, is that Crossfire? You've been caught up in the Crossfire.
Crossfire! Wow, this came up on my play next.
Oh, man. Is Jody gonna push me around today?
Girl, baby, if you could, please give me something, maybe a push to craft services. Please give me something, maybe a push to the services. Anything.
Drink.
Yeah, girl, what you doing? What is happening?
Drink! You gotta stop singing.
Excuse me, did you interrupt? Cause I was rapping.
Just focus on being good.
Cause I'm in the wheelie and you know it is a